As their names suggest, the key and velocity trackers accept as inputs key or note values and velocity or volume values. The devices then process this input through various options to create an output, which is used to control a destination parameter. Although what they measure as an input is different, the two tracker devices share a lot of parameters in common. So, let's take a look at those first. The default input option lets a device receive values from any instrument or sample. But you can restrict this to something specific. The set of three dest boxes are where you set the destination track or sample effects chain, the chosen effect, and the parameter. The min and max sliders set the minimum and maximum values to be used from the range of that destination parameter. By default, the range is 0 to 100%, but this will change to match the parameter type. Note that it's possible to reverse the output mapping by making the min greater than the max. The scaling option can change how the input value will be mapped across the chosen input range. By default, the scaling will be applied in a linear fashion, but you can also select from two exponential and two logarithmic curves. The input range for the velocity tracker simply sets what note velocities are used for the min and max values. Velocities above or below this range still trigger the min or max value, as shown on the output meter. While the input meter displays the velocity that's being received. The key tracker's input range is similar in how it sets what notes are used for the min and max values, but also offers an additional method of control. The default of clamp behaves the same as the velocity tracker, with notes outside of the selected range triggering the min or max output value. When set to soft, however, these outside notes are ignored, so that no change is made to the output. The octave setting disables the user selected range, sets the min note to C, the max note to B, and uses notes from different octaves equally. For example, a C5 has the same input value as a C4 or C3. Exactly what triggers an input value depends on whether the device is used in a track in the pattern editor or within a sampler effects chain. If it's the former, then the value comes from an instrument being played, while the latter uses the playing of samples within an instrument. Red, 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 red. Another important difference is that, as a track effect, input values are only accepted from an instrument that is playing in the same track as the tracker device. Now that might seem obvious, but when in a sampler effects chain, values will be accepted from any track. Also note that a sample does not have to be specifically routed through effects chains in order to trigger any tracker devices within them. The tracker devices can receive multiple values at the same time, and when this happens, the rightmost value is used. This is true for both the pattern editor and the phrase editor. So, what happens when a phrase is triggered from the pattern editor and they have conflicting values? The key note values are transposed around exactly how you would expect. While the velocity, volume values are combined together. For example, a half-velocity phrase note, played at half-velocity in the pattern editor, will have a value of 1/4. You'll also find simpler versions of the key and velocity trackers in the sampler's modulation section. The key device is self-explanatory. But the velocity device now only deals with the 128 possible velocity values. That's 0027F in hexadecimal. In clamp mode, velocities above or below the selected range will trigger the min or max value. In scale mode, however, the 0027F note velocity range is mapped so that it fits within the range selected here.